Good morning, students. Welcome to your science class. Today we will start with the circulatory system. You all know this is the part of the human body. Now, circulatory system. What is circulatory system? It is an organ system that circulates blood throughout the human body. It consists of heart, blood, and blood vessels, namely veins and arteries. Our heart pumps the blood that carries nutrients, oxygen, and other essential things. So, circulatory system is an organ system that circulates blood inside our body, throughout our body. It consists of heart, blood, and blood vessels. And in the blood vessels, there are namely two types of vessels. One is the arteries, another is the veins. Now, our heart pumps the blood that carries nutrients, oxygen, and other essential things. Now, what are the functions of circulatory system? It transports oxygen and nutrients to each of the body cell. Hormones are transported to each cell of body through it. It collects wastes from body cells and transports it to the excretory system. It maintains body temperature. It destroys germs and protects the body against infections. So, circulatory system transports oxygen and other nutrients required by our body to each of the body cell. Secondly, hormones are transported to each cell of our body by the circulatory system. Third one, it collects waste from the body cells and it transports it to the excretory system. Next, it maintains our body temperature. The last one is it destroys the germs and protects our body against infections. Now we will read about the organs. Circulatory system consists of three organs. You all can see. Number one is heart. This is the picture of the heart. Next one is the blood vessels. This is the picture of the blood vessels. And the last one is the blood. Now, this is the picture of the blood. Now, what is heart? Human heart is a muscular organ about the size of a closed fist that pumps blood throughout the body. So, the main function of the heart, which is present in a human body, is to pump blood throughout the whole body. Next one is the blood vessels. These are the networks of tubes that circulate blood to the different part of body. So, the main work of blood vessels is to circulate blood to the different parts of our body. Now, this is the picture of a blood vessel which is present inside our body. Now, the next one is the blood. Blood is a special kind of red colored fluid. Fluid means liquid that flows inside our blood vessels and delivers oxygen and nutrients to the body's cell. So, blood is a special kind of fluid which is red in color and it flows inside our blood vessels. And what does it do? It delivers oxygen and nutrients that are present to our body's cells. Now, we move to the structure of the heart. You all can see the picture of the heart is given. The parts are also mentioned. Now, it consists of four chambers. The first one is two atria. It is also called auricles. These are the upper chambers. Now, upper chambers are known as the left atrium and the right atrium. Now you all can see in the picture, this is the right atrium and this one is the left atrium. So these two are the upper chambers. Now the next one is the two ventricles, the lower chambers. The lower two chambers are known as the left ventricle and the right ventricle. Now you all can see this is the right ventricle and this is the left ventricle. So these two are the lower chambers of the heart and these two are the right or atrium and left atrium are the upper chambers of the heart. And see, look at the picture everyone. Superior, this is the superior vena cava, this is the aorta, this is the pulmonary artery, pulmonary vein, mitral valve, aortic valve, pulmonary valve, tricuspid valve, and these are the two right upper chambers, right atrium and left atrium, and the lower chambers, the right ventricle and the left ventricle. And this one is the inferior vena cava. So this is the superior vena cava and this is the inferior vena cava. Now the functions of the heart. We all have seen the picture of the heart and now we will read about the functions, the various functions of the heart. The right auricle receives deoxygenated blood from different parts of body. The next one is the left auricle receives deoxygenated blood from the lungs. The right ventricle pumps deoxygenated blood to the lungs for purification. The left ventricle pumps the deoxygenated blood from the heart to all parts of the body. Now, what is the meaning of deoxygenated? Deoxygenated is that blood which is rich in carbon dioxide. And what is oxygenated? Oxygenated is that blood which is rich in oxygen. So, these are the various functions of the heart. Now we move to the blood vessels. You all can see the picture of the blood vessel is given. There are three main types of blood vessels. First one is veins. Next one arteries. And the last one is capillaries. What are veins? Veins are the blood vessels that carry impure blood from all parts of the body to the heart. So, the main function of vein is to carry all the impure blood that is present inside the body to the heart. Next one is arteries. Arteries are the blood vessels that carry pure blood from the heart to all parts of the body. You all have read before that the work of the heart is to pump blood. So, arteries carry this pure blood from the heart to all parts of the body. And the last one is capillaries. Capillaries are the tiniest blood vessels that connect arteries and veins and are very thin. Now look at the picture. This is from heart. This is the artery. These are the capillaries. This is the vein and this is to heart. So, the blood is coming from this side, from the heart, and it's moving out from this side to the heart. Now, the next one is blood. There are four basic components of blood. Number one is plasma. Plasma is the yellowish liquid part of the blood. It transports water and nutrients to our body's tissues. So, plasma is a type of blood which is yellowish in color and it is the liquid part. Now, its work is to transport water and nutrients to our body's tissues. Now, the next one is red blood cells, RBCs. RBCs are the blood cells that carry oxygen and also remove carbon dioxide from our body. So, RBCs, they are the blood cells which have oxygen in them and they remove carbon dioxide from our body. The next one, white blood cells, WBCs. These are the blood cells that fight against the various disease causing germs. They are our immunity cells. So white blood cells gives us the immunity power. They gives us power to fight against various diseases. Last one is platelets. These are the components of blood that help in clotting to prevent blood loss in case of any injury. Now you all can see the picture it's given here. These are the white blood cells, which are our immunity cells. This is the platelets, which helps in clotting in any case of injury. And these are the red blood cells that carry oxygen and removes carbon dioxide from our body. Now we will read about the different functions of blood. The various functions of blood are: blood carries oxygen from lungs to the different parts of the body. Blood brings carbon dioxide from cells to the lungs. Blood regulates body temperature. Blood carries waste products like urea from the liver to the kidney for excretion. It carries the digested food from small intestine to all parts of the body. So, first of all, blood carries oxygen from the lungs to the different parts of our body. It also brings carbon dioxide from the cells to the lungs of our body. It regulates our body temperature. It carries waste products like urea from the liver to the kidney so that it gets out from our body for excretion. It carries the digested food from the small intestine to all parts of the body. Next one is, there are some tips for healthy heart. How you can keep your heart healthy? The various ways to keep our heart strong are: number one is manage weight. We should manage our weight because being overweight can increase the risk of heart diseases. Be physically active. Physical activity is great for our heart's health. We should play at least one outdoor game daily. Yoga. Yoga is a physical practice that involves many forms and postures. Yoga not only keeps us fit and healthy, but also helps to heal our heart and it keeps away heart problems. So, the first point is manage weight. We should always keep our body healthy by keeping it, means by managing our weight. Because if we are overweight, then we will be in having increased risk of heart diseases. Next one is physically active. We should be always physically active so that means our heart can be in a good condition. We should always play at least one outdoor game daily. Next one is yoga. You can see a picture of a yoga is given here. It is a physical practice that involves many different kinds of forms and postures. And yoga not only keeps us fit and healthy, but also heals our heart problems. Avoid junk food. Junk food means food rich in fats and unhealthy carbohydrates, which does not contain the vital nutrients essential for our body. We should avoid eating junk food. Now, junk food are those food which does not have any value in our body, which is very unhealthy. So, we should avoid eating junk food. It contains unhealthy carbohydrates and is rich in fats. And it does not contain the vital nutrients that are essential for our body. And the last one is manage stress. Worries and problems lead to stress, which in turn leads to heart diseases. To keep our heart healthy, we should not think too much and share our concerns with our elders. So, you should not be worried or should not have stress for anything. Because if you are stressed, if you are worried, then it will lead to heart diseases. So you should keep your heart healthy. And if you think too much, then if you have lots of stress or worries, then you can share it with your elders. Thank you.
Thank you.